Hello everybody, myself Manisha Singh, working as Assistant Professor in Department of Life Sciences, Shri Guru Ram Rai Institute of Technology and Science, Patel Nagar, Dehradun. I am presenting this paper in International Journal of Science and Research under the heading of Antibacterial Behavior of Guidance. Coming to the introduction, as we all know that plants are utilized as a source of nutrition and healthcare product from ancient times. Plants act as a reservoir of bioactive chemical agents. They are utilized either in the form of traditional preparations or as pure active principles. Due to emergence of multiple drug-resistant strains of microorganisms due to indiscriminate use of antibiotics has generated a renewed interest in herbal medicines. Weeds are unwanted plants which grow along with the crops which found to be resistant to most of microbial diseases as compared to the crops plants. This antimicrobial behavior associated with production of allelopathic interactions. These produces allelochemicals which act as eco-friendly agrochemicals useful as fungicides, pesticides and herbicides. In this regards, objectives of the present study is to evaluate antibacterial behavior of weeds grown in Dehradun, India during winter season associated with crops like wheat and mustard. Material and methodology which is used in this study, first the material, whole plants of common weeds of Dehradun were collected. Some of the plants are Anagelis arvensis, Capsella bursa pastoris, Chinopodium album, Euphorbia helioscopia, Fumaria indica, Nepelium canescens, Plantago major, Ranunculus scleratus, Rumex nepalensis, Sausuria heteromala, Silenconoidea, Stelaria media. Methodology which is used in this study, first the plants were collected from different places of Doon Valley. They were dried in shade at room temperature for 15 to 20 days. The dried plants were crushed to coarse powder using grinder and stored in paper bags for further use. For the extraction of crude drugs, ethanol was used as a solvent. For this, about 50 gram dry plant sample powder were extracted with 200 ml of ethanol in a closed flask, which was allowed to stand for 48 hours. The filtrates were separated by filtration method. The solvent were evaporated using water bath and transferred to weigh airtight container for further analysis. For antibacterial assay of different extract of the studied plant were performed against four bacterial strains which were procured from the Department of Microbiology, Shri Guru Ram Rai Institute of Technology and Sciences, Dehradun. For antibacterial screening, disc diffusion method was used. A pure colony of each of the test bacterial strains were subcultured into 5 ml of nutrient broth using inoculating loop followed by incubation at 37 degrees centigrade for 3 to 4 hours. The dried extract was dissolved in dimethyl sulfoxide which was subjected to preliminary antibacterial screening with a concentration of 500 mg per ml. About 0.1 ml of inoculum was spread on solidified Müller-Hinton agar surface. Sterile 6 mm diameter Wattman number 41 filter paper disc were dipped and placed onto Müller-Hinton agar media against the studied bacterial strains. minimum inhibitory concentration value were determined against those bacterial strains which showed high sensitivity during preliminary antibacterial testing, which was performed by serial dilution of active concentrated extract in pure dimethyl sulfoxide to achieve a decreasing concentration range of 500 mg per ml to 31.25 mg per ml. The sensitivities of all the bacterial strains were observed against standard drug streptomycin and against dimethyl sulfoxide, which are used as positive and negative control respectively. Findings of the present study: as we all know that weeds may be used for food or medicinal purposes. They do not create any side effect to human body, while chemical based antibiotics does have. These compounds exhibit several biological properties such as phytotoxic, antimicrobial, antifungal, insecticidal, etc. The findings of the present study are such as: number 1, the nature and yield of crude extract. The maximum percentage of crude extract yield was obtained in still area media 10.70%, followed by plantago measure 7.734% out of all the studied 12 plant extract. This table shows yield of crude extract of weeds from ethanol solvent of all the 12 plants. Antibacterial assay: all these studied plant extract showed antibacterial activity against the bacterial strains. Antibacterial studies was performed by using zone of inhibition against the bacterial strains such as Staphylococcus epidermidis, Staphylococcus aureus, Salmonella typhimurium, Pseudomonas aeruginosa. This figure shows zone of inhibition against the bacterial strains. Out of 12 extract, Euphorbia helioscopia extract were found to be most active because it showed maximum zone of inhibition against bacterial strains. Therefore, MIC was carried out only for Euphorbia helioscopia extract against those bacterial strains which showed maximum zone of inhibition, which is greater than 10. Minimum inhibitory concentration analysis. This is important in diagnostic laboratories to confirm resistance of microorganism to an antimicrobial agent and to monitor the activity of new antimicrobial agents. Lower MIC value indicate better antimicrobial agents. MIC analysis was performed by serial dilution of concentrated ethanol extract in pure dimethyl sulfoxide range of 500 mg per ml to 62.5 mg per ml. On performing MIC analysis for Euphorbia helioscopia extract, the result revealed that Pseudomonas aeruginosa were sensitive against 62.5 mg per ml concentration of extract, thereby 62.5 mg per ml as their MIC value. Staphylococcus epidermidis, Staphylococcus aureus, Salmonella typhimurium were sensitive against 250 mg per ml concentration of extract, therefore MIC value was 250 mg per ml of these samples. This table shows minimum inhibitory concentration of Euphorbia helioscopia extract. This table shows zone of inhibition of positive and negative control against all the four bacterial strains. Coming to the conclusion, out of 12 extract acid, the Euphorbia helioscopia shows maximum activity against all the bacterial strains. In future, plant extract of weeds exploited to control various bacterial infection, as plant extract revealed the presence of various phytoconstituents such as glycosides, triterpenoids, phenols and flavonoids. These are some of the references which are used in this text. Thanking you.